And then we come to our last lie. A little bit of a difficult lie to wrap your mind around. It's gonna take something of a dismount with a half twist and a stick to landing to get to, because it's one of the hardest ones to wrap your mind around. And that's because it's not really a real thing. It's something of a mythology that has grown up around what we call the church. Well, we all know the church is real, but what is the church? You hear people talking about the church all the time. The church does this, the church ought to be like that, but nobody can seem to agree what the church really is. Almost like it's some mythological creature we're all trying to hunt down, like it's maybe a were-church, something you gotta pin down and maybe capture with a silver bullet to get it all to work the way that it is. And so we go chasing after it and trying to pin it down, trying to figure out what the church is. We go on a quest, shooting at anything we can find to try to make the church appear the way it ought to be. And then you look around and all you see are churches that look like little old women that are just pockmarked and ugly and falling apart, wrinkled faces sitting in a corner. They can barely keep their doors open. They can't afford to pay their pastors. Well, that can't be the church. Maybe we should fix the church. That's what pragmatism says when he knocks on the door selling you the next thing he wants to sell you. He says, I got an idea. Let's run some tests on this church. We strap her down, we stick some needles in her arm, and then she turns into a monster. She grows fangs and pointy ears and starts to fight back. Well, then is this the church at all, or are we just killing the real church? That's the next rule that every Christian ought to break as often as possible.